There is no other sport.
The foundation of a good hockey club is a good foundation.
That's right.
Quack like a duck.
Quack.
Martin, 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 Verdure.
Wow.
Don't you love it?
Why are you guys all here?
This is the Stanley Cup. You do what you have to do to win.
Because nothing else matters.
This is NHL Cool Shots. This week, celebrities team up with Islander alumni to play a charity hockey game for a worthy cause. Matthew Perry of TV's Friends was on hand to lace up the skates.
You're a regular on the all-star celebrity hockey team.
Yeah.
Oh, well, at least you try to be, right? Whenever you're in shape, right?
Whenever.
And you gotta be in shape to make plays like these. The best of March in Cool Cuts.
Welcome to Nassau Coliseum, home of the New York Islanders, one of the most storied franchises in the NHL. In the early 80s, the Islanders won four consecutive Stanley Cups, and today some of the heroes of the Islanders' past are joining forces with some Hollywood celebrities to face off against the Gift of Life team for a very important cause. Hello, everyone. I'm Jennifer Smith, and I'm outside the team dressing rooms being joined now by Dr. Levchuk. Doctor, tell me all about today's Skate for Life and how the program got started.
Well, we wanted to raise the awareness of children all over the world needing open heart surgery. The Gift of Life is an organization that brings children over, and the Skate for Life is just a vehicle not only to raise funds, but to raise awareness.
Now, I heard there's a special story about Matthew Perry's involvement today.
Yes, Matthew was approached by us, and his very good friend, Keith Resnick, lost a child to congenital heart disease. And when we talked to Matthew and said that we would like to get him involved and have him choose personally candidates for our program, he just jumped at our offer and wanted to come out and skate with us.
All right, well, I know it's time for you to go get your skates laced up and hit the ice for today's game. So while they do that, we're going to give you all access to Ron Howard's brand new movie, Ed TV.
Morning. I'm Ed.
Ed TV is a movie about Ed Pickerny's instant fame and sharing his life with a few million of his closest friends. The San Jose Arena was used to shoot a sequence with the star of the film, Matthew McConaughey.
First sign of his sort of mega success is that the Sharks invite him to drive the Zamboni, and so he leaps at the opportunity.
It's gonna be fun, man. It's gonna be fun.
To shoot this scene, the technical aspect had to be just right.
We've got four cameras going at each intermission. The first intermission, we have two cameras rigged on the Zamboni. We are ready. This train is leaving the station at the first intermission, and we better be on it.
Who knew this game could be this cool?
I love hockey.
Jenna Elfman gets to be McConaughey's Zamboni date for the evening.
I just can't believe that we're in the middle of a game and we're shooting this movie. Like, that is cool.
Crowd started getting into it. Matthew McConaughey was psyching himself up to take the ice in front of over 17,000 fans.
I was so wishing I was sitting on it next to him going,
yay! Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a thank you to tonight's Zamboni driver, Ed Pickerty.
We're finished now, we're all elated, everything works, nobody screwed up, so we got our work done tonight.
Bye!
Both teams are on the ice warming up, and I'm being joined now by a guy that most of you know as Chandler Bing from the hit TV show Friends, Matthew Perry. Matt, any predictions for today's game?
I think it's going to be a high-scoring affair. I'm just going to try to stay on my feet because I haven't played this game in a few years, and these guys are looking kind of serious.
Well, now, I know that you are a huge Senators fan, right. And if things keep going the way they are, Jacques Martin could lead that talented team to a Stanley Cup victory. How would you feel if they won it all?
I'd feel great. I'll be showing up to a lot of those games if they get that far, that's for sure.
All right, well, we'll let you get back out there and warm up. I hear those doctors, there's some pretty stiff competition.
Yeah, I'm very frightened.
Well, right now, we're going to hear from some more Hollywood superstars about their passion for the Stanley Cup.
Bobby Orr's Stanley Cup winning goal, 69-70 Bruins. And that famous shot of him flying through the air was the thing that we would always try to recreate, even on concrete when we played street hockey.
We play street hockey, and, you know, as you're running in, you're like, 2 seconds left for the Stanley Cup! Score! And, yeah, we do our little victory laps with the Cup. And I grew up a Ranger fan, so there was an awful long drought. The Cup didn't come here this city for a long time.
My fondest memories were seeing Game 7 and seeing them win for the first time in my life. Not only that, but that night I went in search of the Cup and I found the Cup. Me and my friend got in a cab and said, take us to the Cup.
Did you drink from the Cup?
Yeah.
How awesome was that?
It was unbelievable.
1, 2, 3, 4!
Academy Award winner Tom Hanks.
When I got interested in the sport, it was when the Kings went to the Stanley Cup Finals with Montreal, and I realized that it's like it's ballet and brute strength.
If you were going to do a movie, a hockey movie, and you could cast yourself to play any part, and the storyline could be anything, what would it be?
I'd hoist the cup over my head.
NHL is the coolest game on earth.
Can I keep this?
Coming up, say hello to the new voice of the Atlanta Thrashers, the wild and wacky Scott Farrell.
Gotta love this place, the Phillips Arena, my new home. I love it. You gotta love, drop the puck, go in the corner and hit somebody.
NHL Cool Shots is brought to you by Nike. By Air Canada, the official airline of the NHL in Canada. By Speedstick, tough 24-hour protection. And by Powerade. Keep moving, keep pushing, keep playing. The hottest half hour on TV featuring the coolest game on earth will return after these messages. Watching NHL Cool Shot.
Oh, baby, what a goal.
Well, there you go. I finally turned the red light on. Let's take a look at the greatest goals for the past week. I gotta go lay down.
Well, Dave, you may be tired, but with 1 week remaining in the regular season, these guys are flying high heading into the playoffs.
Roll tape at home. This is a highlight goal right here. Shot! Score!
The new look Red Wings are gunning for their third consecutive Stanley Cup. Speaking of new look, check out Theo Fleury of the Avalanche putting out an old flame. The Senators are battling for the number one seed in the East, and with plays like this, it may be their year to shine. Jaromir Jagr is single-handedly leading the Penguins into the playoffs, and himself the possible league MVP honors.
Here, Jagr one-on-one makes a little move backhander. He shows a score. How he beats Hosley. Turns him inside out. He doesn't know whether to cry or wind his horn.
It's time now for Anaheim's Paul Kariya to blast us into the plays of the week.
Score! Paul Kariya rifles one by Mike Richter.
These sweet setups left the goalies with nowhere to hide.
Left side in front of the center. He shoots and scores.
Oh, what quick hand by Drury to score on the rebound.
We top off red light with some solo efforts.
Attack, Richie walking in. He scores! What a goal!
Tchaikovsky with lingering. Tchaikovsky darts to the net. Backhand, he scores!
On the right wing side with a wrist shot.
With construction in full swing on the new home of the Atlanta Thrashers, a new voice has arrived to pump up interest.
Hey, Atlanta, what's up? Burrell's back. Your boy on the bench.
The bad tea, the broken egg, the bad apple with a bad attitude.
Hockey's radical radio personality, Scott Burrell,
let me have it, champ!
Has been named to handle the Thrashers play-by-play.
Gonna be fun. I'm thinking, you know, expansion. They had to bring in Pharrell because the people of Atlanta needed a little dose of like shock, a little thrash. You got the Thrashers, you got Thrash Boys, Pharrell.
This will be his first play-by-play gig, but Scott's a hockey lover from way back as he demonstrated nightly on a syndicated show, Pharrell on the Bench.
Ah, the pain. Everybody knows I do Pharrell on the Bench nationally, but I've never really called an NHL game in my life. I'm really raw, if you will, but we're going to give it a whirl. We're going to wing it. I'm going to do a whole new style.
Hey, John.
Yeah.
How's it going?
Well, it's going a little rough out there. We're not hitting on any passes. It's not cohesive. We don't have a team leader out there. Where's Moriarty?
Oh, you know, he's not available. He's still over at MSG trying to get into the Rangers celebrity
game.
Well,
that's the problem. Excuse me.
Oh, sorry.
Hey, John, what's the key? What are you going to have to do to turn this thing around?
Well, you're watching. We're getting pushed around out there, playing like a bunch of wusses. We need some muscle out there. I don't know where we're going to find that.
Well, John, in this week's Power Performers, we begin by flexing some muscle. While some prefer force, these guys prefer sheer artistry.
To the net, Eastwood, saved by Fitzpatrick, a beauty!
Outstanding goaltending here tonight. Outstanding goaltending.
Down the middle court, no!
But not everyone wants to be like Mike. These guys want to be like Dominic.
Kozlov, open net shot, what a save!
That was Hasek.
That looked exactly like a Dominic Hasek save.
That's picture perfect.
Up next, a charity hockey game that featured celebrity speed and veteran strategy.
I'm breaking really fast through the middle.
Okay.
Well, not really fast.
Out here, we all want to play like the pros. Stop pucks like the superhuman Dominic Hasek. Fly like Theo Fleury. And roof it like Mike Modano. What's weird is, sometimes they wish they could play like us. Like when they're tied and the rules make them stop. We just keep playing.
You should have eaten before the game.
Hungry? Extra hungry? Try McDonald's new Big Extra Burger. Cool tomato, crisp lettuce, and one huge specially seasoned beef patty. Go for the whole meal for just $3.99.
Pull the goalie.
Pull them both.
Welcome back to NHL Cool Shots. Let's go to Los Angeles to learn more hockey terms in this week's Moriarty Minute.
All right, I'm here with Jamie Storr of the LA Kings. Obviously, we are not talking about taking a face-off. Jamie, the five hole. Come on, what's that about?
Well, I think it was a par three, and I think I hooked it into the sand.
No. The five hole for a goaltender.
Oh, okay.
Pass to Korean, over the line, moves to the outside, he shoots, he scores! Five hole!
It's basically come off a shooter tutor, I think. They basically had the 1-2 and then the 3-4 hole and the five holes in the middle. So they kept using the five holes, referenced anything between the legs, and you know it stuck with them, you know, through the years.
He shoots and scores right through the five hole. 5 minute shot. He thinks he shoots, he scores! Terrible goal through the five hole.
Do goalies hate hearing that?
After a while, you do. I mean, it's a tough shot to stop. It's one of those things where, you know, you'll always want to take away the five hole.
Right down the middle, all alone, he shoots! Saved by Jamie Storr!
All right, I'm going to the five hole, everybody. All right, Jamie? Not even close. That's why he's in the NHL. That's why all I can do is talk to him. Thanks, Jamie.
Thanks a lot.
Awesome.
Here with Clark Gillies, enforcer extraordinaire. You know, there's one thing I've always wanted to know about you.
Mm-hmm.
What's your favorite band?
Everclear.
Really?
Yeah.
Favorite song?
One Hit Wonder. And I'll tell you what, it better be on Cool Cuts, too.
What Clark wants, Clark gets. Here's the best plays of March.
Yeah.
I'm here with Dave Coulier. Nice work on the game-winning goal. You look pretty good out here today.
Well, thanks. You know, I finally just kept my eyes closed and fired away. I think that was the secret.
Now, as a father, being able to participate in an event like this must have really special meaning to you.
Yeah, I brought my son to this game today, and I was explaining to him today what we're really doing other than having fun and playing hockey with famous hockey players and celebrities. And he really, at that point, he kind of got it and even wanted to lend his own support. So it's a good message to send out to all these people and a great group of people.
All right, well, right now we're going to take a look back at today's classic showdown here at Nassau Coliseum.
This second annual Skate for Life hockey game matched up not only two competitive hockey teams, but also some very special children with their sponsors. An opportunity for all to see what a Skate for Life really meant. With that in mind, it was time to hit the ice. And although it was a friendly game, everyone put their skills to the test.
Is there any chance we can get all these guys to go up at the same time so we can have a 3-on-0?
This is a blast. Hey, I'm spotting him so much ice time, I'm going to move up front.
Shoot, too, man. Don't always look for me. You're going to be whatever you want to do.
Help me pass it back here. Whoa! You didn't see that, did you, Kenny? Is that good?
You want to play left one?
I'll play anything you want. Sure.
Guitar, bass guitar.
Anything.
I planned it that way. I pass over the top, and then you pass it. Fools them every time.
Here's the plan. I'm breaking really fast through the middle.
Okay.
Well, not really fast.
I got to give you the business. They assigned it.
Okay, baby.
Okay, I'm ready. Right here with the puck. Oh, I can see that hole right through there. Five hole tweeners right now. Let's go, boys.
The game stayed close throughout, with the New York Islander alumni team and their celebrity guests putting on quite a show. But the Gift of Life team evened the score and kept the pressure on.
You and me, man, you and I have got to step up.
That's right.
Matthew Perry took to the ice and kept his word, making a pass to Islander great Bobby Nystrom for the go-ahead goal. But the doctors and area professionals got right back to business.
Come on, boys, let's get one back here.
Raising over $150,000 for the Gift of Life program, they were all winners. But the game was still tied until Dave Coulier tapped in the game winner. The final score, 7-6.
We had a blast. Thanks. Great, thanks. Great.
Coming up, due to his aggressive style of play, Matthew Perry doesn't have as many friends on the ice as he does on TV.
I think one game I actually wore a helmet that said actor on it so that they knew not to hit me.
Welcome back to NHL Cool Shots, joined now by everybody's friend, Matthew Perry. Great job out there today.
Thank you. You clearly were not watching. Yeah, it was fun. I mean, I played online with Nystrom, so it doesn't get better than that. And there's numbers like up here.
Nervous at all being on the ice with guys like that?
No, because they know that I'm an actor, and I think one game I actually wore a helmet that said actor on it so that they knew not to hit me.
Now, you flew all the way across the country to participate in today's game. Why? And why was it so important to be here?
One of the reasons is the casting director to the show Friends, daughter died to Williams disease, and her name was Lily Claire, and for the Lily Claire Foundation, one of the wonderful doctors down here agreed to perform life-saving surgery for these two kids, so I was here in a heartbeat, of course.
Your time is so limited. Why do you choose to participate in things like this?
Well, there's two reasons. One, the funny reason is that we get to actors pretend that we're pro hockey players for, you know, a weekend. And, you know, our sticks sometimes have our names on it. It's like the pros, you know, and that's fun. And then also, you know, just to be able to have fun while doing good for different charities around the world, that's, you know, it's perfect. And that's why we all come out, because we're making money for really good causes and we get to pretend like we're pros.
Now, growing up, did you ever have dreams of hoisting the cup over your head?
Oh, yeah. Well, I grew up in Canada, so it's the law that you play hockey. So I didn't play baseball, I played hockey all the time. And then I realized at the age of about 8 that I had no shot.
Well, at least you got smart early on.
I literally mean no shot. I couldn't shoot.
Oh, we just fired the pod!
A couple years ago, you made some promos for the NHL.
Yeah. This is the Stanley Cup.
Now, did you feel at all a little upstaged by the Cup?
You know, I was pretty funny in those spots. I don't know if you were.
Can you hand me my soda, please?
Yeah.
It's deflected to the ground for another great souvenir.
That was my puck.
So you watch a lot of hockey, I take it.
Yeah.
Stanley Cup prediction.
Well, I have to. I'm a huge Ottawa Senators fan because I've been, you know, after this Detroit trade, I think it's going to be Detroit. But I have to go for my Senators because I was a fan of theirs that first season when they won 9 games. One game on the road the whole year.
So that, you know, the Ottawa Senators are just tearing up the East.
Yeah.
They're one of the best teams in the NHL. You're on the top-rated sitcom where you get to kiss Courtney Cox from time to time.
Yeah.
Does it get any better
it
for
you? It doesn't. Matt? It can't get better than that.
Right.
I think I'm peaking right as we speak.
Well, since he's peaking right now, why don't you say goodbye, Matt?
Goodbye, Matt.
See you next week on NHL Cool Shots.
NHL Cool Shots is brought to you by Nike. By Powerade. Keep moving, keep pushing, keep playing. By Speedstick. Tough 24-hour protection. And by Air Canada, the official airline of the NHL in Canada. Thanks for watching NHL Cool Shots. We'll see you next week from Ottawa for more of the coolest game on earth.
Hi, I'm Matthew Ferry. Here's what's coming up next week on Cool Shots from Ottawa, the home of the best team in the NHL.
At a local charity event, the first-place Senators proved they deserve top billing for their work off the ice.
It's a great thing. We're having a silent auction, phone-in auction, and like I said, just raising money and helping the kids.
Hi, I'm Matthew Ferry. Here's what I'm going to start again.
Thank you. I'll push you.
Hi, I'm Matthew Perry. I don't know what I'm...
You're wasting your time out here. Especially trying to guard me.
You're a regular on the all-star celebrity hockey team. Oh, well, at least you try to be, right? Whenever you're in shape, right?
Whenever. Hey, I have a good suntan going.
You see this red, folks? That's not really red.
That's suntan.
That's Matthew Perry, out of shape. A little... He's breathing really hard.
Listen,
right
you're
now.
You're up high. I can push you right over.
I hope it comes here. Oh, I really hope I get it. I know what to do with it if I get it. They don't ever find me though. Oh, I'm cutting down.
This is the same thing. It feels like the same thing. Wow. What a feeling.
It's double hit.